Research is indicating that the arts sector is going to be hit twice as hard as the rest of the economy. Theatres in particular face a $3 billion revenue loss and an estimated loss of 12,000 jobs. And this doesn't even take into account any of the audience's reluctance to return to their venues. Theatre makers, companies and performers have invested their whole lives into the arts. They bare their hearts and souls to create performances which capture the audience's attention. They help us communicate, share emotions, and provide moments of escape and solitude among the daily stresses of life.
There are numerous petitions asking the government to take further actions to help save our art industry. While we may be too young to sign these, we are not going to stand by and do nothing. We are the future of the arts, but we need the industry to still be standing when it's our turn to take the stage. Here's how you can help us. We have created this remote performance with the help of our fellow performing arts students and teachers. Please watch it, enjoy it, and hopefully feel inspired by it. Then, if you feel you are able to, please donate via the link to our Just Giving page. We are raising money for Acting for Others, a group of charities who provide financial and emotional support to individuals in the theatre industry during a time of crisis. You are buying your ticket retrospectively to our performance, and you decide the price. Any donation that you can make will be greatly appreciated. Thank you.
Like a small boat on the ocean, sending big waves into motion. Like how a single word can make a heart open. I might only have one match, but I can make an explosion. And all those things I didn't say were wrecking balls. what have I left in me? Here's the thing, we started out friends. It was cool when it was all pretend. Yeah, yeah, since you've been gone. You dedicated, you took the time. It wasn't long until I called you mine. Yeah, yeah, since you've been gone. And all you'd ever hear me say is how I picture me with you. That's all you'd ever hear me say.
Out of the night that covers me,
black as the pit from pole to pole,
I think wherever ghosts may be,
for my unconquerable soul,
the fell clutch of circumstance,
I have not winced nor cried aloud.
Under the bludgeonings of chance,
my head is bloody, but I'm bowed.
Beyond this place of wrath and tears
looms but the horror of the shade, and yet the menace of the years
finds and shall find me unafraid.
It matters not how straight the gate,
how charged the scroll.
I am the captain of my soul.